Hey, what's up? It's Rob Balasabas with the Social Media Club YouTube channel, and today I'm going to talk to you about closed captions for your videos. Before I do, I want to make sure that you are clicking subscribe and also clicking that notification bell so that you can get notified when I post up new videos on different social media, digital marketing, and video marketing tutorials, as well as some of the behind the scenes vlogs that I am also sharing on this channel. First, say thank you to Tim Hortons, Large Double Double, Canada, Go Canada Go. It's my go-to every morning. A big part of why we create closed captions for videos nowadays when we're sharing it on social media and all the different channels is because most people are watching videos on their phones. When they're commuting, when they're on the train, on the bus, when they are, hopefully not when they're driving, when they are on the go, they're watching them on their phones. And a lot of the times the videos are on mute because they don't want people to hear what they're watching and those kind of things. They don't want to bother their coworkers, so they're on mute. If your videos don't have closed captions, they're scrolling past your videos. To drive this home, I want to share a few quick stats on video mobile consumption on mobile devices right now. First, according to Invisia, mobile video consumption rises 100% every single year. This is just the way humans are made. Humans would rather consume video content, watch videos, versus reading a blog or listening to a podcast. When I was in school, if there was a book report and that book had a movie, I would definitely go and watch the movie versus reading the book. Don't tell anyone, I still got a passing grade, but that is just how humans work. According to Cisco, by 2022, online videos will make up more than 82% of all consumer internet traffic, 15 times higher than it was in 2017. Another one here from Quartz says that Facebook executives predicted that their platform will be majority, almost all video and no text by 2021. We're seeing this now. You're seeing so much video content on Facebook, on Instagram, on LinkedIn. It's what people are consuming, so that's what people are creating. This is a really interesting one. WordStream says that 59% of executives say that they would rather watch a video than read text. If you are in the B2B space, executives are watching videos rather than reading these days. Here's one from eMarketer. 75% of all video plays are on mobile devices. Two more quick facts here. 92% of users watching video on mobile will share it with others. So as long as your video is good content, it's quality, it's bringing value, it's going to be shared. And the last one that I want to share with you is by 2020, according to Cisco, close to 1 million minutes of video will cross the internet per second. That's incredible. That's just like mind blowing. All right, first of all, sorry about this shadow. I'm right here and there's a building across from me that's reflecting the light back. So I have to kind of zigzag and dodge the light here. But okay, I want to share with you now the 5 closed caption tools that I personally use. And I'm going to tell you my favorite one that I use the most in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. It's the first one. Rev.com is probably the most well-known closed caption tool out there on the market. They are very easy to use. I'm actually good friends with their previous director of marketing. Very, very solid tool. They have a lot of really good functions. They're continually updating and moving. So they have a very established brand as well. And so they have a couple different options here. So there is transcription, which is $1 per minute. So you can convert your audio or video to text. So it's really good if you want to create blog posts, for example, right? So if you want to take your videos or your podcast and you want to turn that into a blog post, very simple way to repurpose your content to get out to a different channel. Also, they have captions, which is $1 a minute. And also the last one that they have here that's really cool, I'm going to move my face to the other side, is they have foreign subtitles. Foreign subtitles work really well for YouTube, where you can have multiple versions of your closed captions in different languages. So this one is a little bit higher cost. It's $3 to $7 per minute. But if your market is primarily speaking those other languages, then this is a very good investment. Okay, so the second tool that I'd like to show you is Temi.com. Now Temi, in full transparency, is actually owned by Rev.com. The only difference with Temi is that it is AI based. You're paying for the use of their AI tool to basically provide closed captions for your videos or your audio files. That being said, it is going to be cheaper. It is only 10 cents a minute, as you can see here. So it is a smaller cost. So it is still a very good platform, but you do still need to do a bit of manual work yourself just to get it right versus rev.com, which is an actual person transcribing your videos. The next tool I want to share with you is one that I love the most, Quick. Quick is a really awesome tool. If you're following me on LinkedIn, you might have seen a video of me unboxing some swag from my friends at Quick. Now, I'm not affiliated with Quick. I'm not part of Quick. They don't pay me. Actually, none of these companies pay me to talk about them in this video. I'm just wanting to share some resources with you to create better videos and help you get your videos out to more people and get more reach and engagement. That being said, Quick is a really awesome tool. They're based in Wichita. They're fairly new to the market. They are just doing their pre-launch right now. It is June 2019, so if you're watching this and it is 2021 already, Quick has probably already blown up and in multiple countries and multiple offices. But as of right now, they're based in Wichita. My good friends Jason and Chrissy are the co-founders of Quick. And so the nice thing about Quick is that you can use them on mobile and you can also use them on your desktop. The other thing about Quick is that you can create SRT files, which is the closed caption files, that you can then use to upload to LinkedIn or Facebook. It's a separate closed caption file from your videos. The other really cool thing about Quick though is that you can also bake in your closed captions into the videos itself. So you don't have to upload a separate SRT file when you're uploading your videos to LinkedIn or Facebook or any of those tools. Also, on Instagram, for example, there is no way to upload an SRT file. So the only way that you can get closed captions on your Instagram videos or IGTV videos or Instagram story videos is by baking it in to the video itself. Here's an example of a video that I put through Quick. So you can see here that the closed captions are actually showing up in the videos now. This is actually part of the video. It is not an SRT file that I uploaded. It's baked right into the video. So wherever I upload this video, the subtitles will just show up as part of the video. There's no toggle for turning the subtitles on or off. So that's really the cool thing about Quick. Again, they are on soft launch, beta launch right now. So if you want to test them out, I think they have 10 free minutes for the first month. Go check them out. Say hi to Jason and Chrissy. Tell them that Rob sent you. And I'm sure they'll hook you up. All right, the fourth tool that I want to show you is Headliner, headliner.app. Now, this is a tool that was actually shared with me by my good friend Stephanie Liu, who's always on the cutting edge of all things video marketing. So this is a really cool tool as well. So I had actually used this for a little while. It was not as accurate as I had liked, but it is still a very good tool. So if you want to check them out, headliner.app is the way to go. It's very similar to Quick. Go check them out, headliner.app. And the last tool that I want to share with you today is speedscriber.com. Now, this is actually a separate app and it is only good for Macs. It is a very useful tool. I find that it's really easy to make edits and corrections. Again, most of these transcription tools are not 100% accurate unless you have someone actually doing them, like an actual human being transcribing it for you, like rev.com, which costs way more. But a lot of these tools are fairly accurate, 90 to 95%, and you have to do some small edits. You can actually see it on their homepage here. This is what the interface looks like. So you can have multiple speakers that shows up, and then you can also just quickly make edits. They've got some shortcuts to when you're making those edits. So hotkeys and things like that, that they have set in place to make edits a lot easier for you. Now the cost to this is fairly reasonable and you just have to buy credits ahead of time. For the most part, it's about 50 cents a minute. It's somewhere in between Rev and Temi and Quick. As your credits, you know, get lower and lower, then you just need to refill your credit bank here. So again, a really easy tool. I like it. I used it as well at Thinkific. Check them out. It is only good for Macs. So if you are on Windows, then unfortunately it won't work. But if you have a Mac, then it's good to go. All right, there you have it. So those are my five tools when it comes to closed captions that I would recommend. The one that I would try first is Quick. So go ahead, go check them out. If you have any questions around closed captioning, anything like that, video marketing, that's what I'm here for. Feel free to leave me a comment with your questions. Also, if you want to talk about what you're doing with your marketing, with your video content creation, with your content marketing, feel free to reach out to me. You know, we can do a virtual coffee, we can hop on a call, we can connect on a DM, and we can kind of start chatting about it. So I would love to help you with anything that you're working on and even just give you some free tips or advice. That's what I'm here for, and answer any questions that you have. So make sure that you are subscribing to this channel, clicking that notification bell, and I will see you in the next video.